We're asked to determine the derivative function for each given function. First, we have f of x equals negative 3 times cosine to the 4th x. The first thing to recognize here is that we have a composite function, and therefore to find the derivative function, we'll have to apply the chain rule. When applying the chain rule, we need to identify the inner function, which we often identify as u. To identify the inner function here, it might be helpful to rewrite the function f of x as negative 3 times the 4th power of cosine x. In this form, notice it's easier to identify that the inner function u is equal to cosine x. So if we have u equals cosine x, when applying the chain rule, we also have to find u prime. U prime is a derivative of cosine x, which is negative sine x. And now if it's helpful, we can think of our function f as just negative 3 u to the 4th, and apply the chain rule with the power rule. Looking at our notes, the derivative of u to the power of n with respect to x is equal to n times u to the power of n minus 1 times u prime. This indicates that f prime of x is equal to the derivative of negative 3 u to the 4th with respect to x. We multiply by 4, which gives us negative 12. U to the power of 4 minus 1, which gives us a power of 3, and then times u prime. And now we need to write this back in terms of x using u equals cosine x and u prime equals negative sine x. This gives us f prime of x is equal to negative 12 times u to the third, which is really cosine x to the third, and times u prime, which is negative sine x. Let's go ahead and simplify this. Let's write this as f prime of x equals negative 12 cosine cubed x times sine x. And now let's look at h of x. H of x equals negative 3 cosine of x to the fourth. Notice for this composite function, the inner function u is equal to x to the fourth. So if we have u equals x to the fourth, we know u prime is equal to 4x cubed. And again, if it's helpful, we can think of our function h as just negative 3 cosine u. Now again, looking at our formulas, the derivative of cosine u with respect to x is equal to negative sine u times u prime, which indicates h prime of x is equal to the derivative of negative 3 cosine u with respect to x, which is negative 3 times the derivative of cosine u with respect to x, which gives us negative sine u times u prime. Running it back in terms of x, we have h prime of x is equal to positive 3 times sine of u, which is x to the fourth, times u prime, which is 4x cubed. Let's write this one more time. H prime of x is equal to 12x to the third sine of x to the fourth. And now let's look at g of x. G of x equals 4 times sine cubed of x. Let's rewrite the given function as 4 times the cube of sine x, where the inner function u is sine x. So if u equals sine x, we know u prime is equal to cosine x. And again, we can think of our function g as just 4 u to the third. And therefore, g prime of x is equal to, we'd multiply by 3, 4 times 3 is 12, u to the power of 3 minus 1, which is 2, times u prime. Again, writing this back in terms of x, we have g prime of x equals 12 times u squared is the square of sine x, and u prime is cosine x. Let's write this one more time as g prime of x equals 12 times sine squared x times cosine x. And for our last example, we have j of x equals 4 sine of x cubed. For j of x, the inner function u is equal to x cubed. So if u equals x cubed, u prime is equal to 3x squared. And we can think of the given function as just 4 sine u. which indicates j prime of x is equal to the derivative of 4 sine u with respect to x, which is equal to 4 times cosine u times u prime. Writing it back in terms of x, we have j prime of x equals 4 times cosine u is cosine x cubed, and u prime is equal to 3x squared. Simplifying one more time, we have j prime of x equals 12x squared cosine of x cubed. I hope you found this helpful.